sorry for the, as Ashley Solasa hits that one between the third baseman and shortstop to tie the game. That sends in Sedarian McAllister to tie the game 4-4. Sorry for the miscommunication. Looks like the stream might have went down. As a little recap, Sedarian McAllister led off the inning with a triple to center field. That then led to a Lord Gutierrez pop-up to left field. Then Sierra Mello, who hit a two-run home run in the bottom of the first inning, walked, which then led to that Ashley Solasa RBI single. So now the game is tied 4-4 in the bottom of the third inning. Up now is Kenzie Gones, who is now down in the count 0-1. There's one out in the inning. Ashley Solasa, base runner at first, while Sierra Mello, the base runner at third. That one up the middle for strike number two, so Kenzie Gones down 0-2 now. So big game for Ashley Solasa the senior day. The 0-2 pitch is fouled back. Solo home run for Solasa in the bottom of the first inning, which gave the Wolfpack a 3-0 lead. And then just now hitting a RBI single. So two RBIs currently for Solasa out of the four Wolfpack runs. And Sierra Mello will have the other two after her two-run home run in the bottom of the first. That one just outside 2-2. Also for those who might have missed it, there have been two pitching changes for the UNLV Rebels. Charlie Masterson started off the game, then was switched for Jasmine Martin, and now currently pitching is Jenny Bressler. That one's also fouled back, still 1-2 count. Bressler was the starting pitcher in the first game of the doubleheader yesterday. The 1-2 pitch, and a swing and a miss. So Kenzie Gones is the second out of the inning as the Wolfpack still have runners on the corners with two out. Up now is the catcher, Haley Berta. For those who might have also missed, today is senior day. After the conclusion of this game, we will be celebrating the Nevada Wolfpack seniors. The first pitch. That one's fouled back over here in the parking lot for strike number one. Wolfpack lineup has a single one of their seniors starting this game. That includes Sedarian McAllister, Kenzie Gones, Haley Berta, and then Julia Jensen on the mound. And Ashley Solasa. That one's hit to left field, and that'll be caught by the left fielder, Maddie Schmidt. The Wolfpack are able to tie the game after Sedarian McAllister triple and then Ashley Solasa RBI singles. So now the game is tied 4-4 heading into the fourth inning.
In the inning for the Wolfpack, one run on two hits, no errors, two runners left on base.
It's senior day here at Christina M. Hickson Park, and a big day for the Nevada Wolfpack seniors, as all four of their runs this game have come from their seniors. Ashley Salas, a solo home run, and a two-run home run. Julia Jensen, currently on the mound, has pitched three innings, five allowed hits, four earned runs, two walks, and five strikeouts as that first pitch is outside for ball one. Your day, but happy Mother's Day to all the mothers watching out there. The 2-0 pitch. It's called inside for strike number one. So 2-1 pitch for the batter Samantha Diaz, who has three of the four runs. She hit a three-run home run in the top of the second. A swing and a miss. That's strike number two. So 2-2 count now for Diaz. The 2-2 pitch. That is a swing. So a swing and a miss. The Diaz give Julia Jensen. That's now so far on the day, your 3.1 innings.
Now back to UNLV.
Batting ninth, Lauren, third baseman, who currently is 1-for-1 on the day. The first pitch, that one's hit to the second baseman, Mello, and she's easily able to get a glove on that for the second out. So the top of the Rebels order will be back up as Maddie Schmidt is back up to bat. Schmidt currently on the day is 1-for-2 with a RBI. This was because of the Lauren Barker single, which then led to the Maddie Schmidt RBI. Maddie Schmidt also was Jensen's first strikeout victim in the top of the first inning. That one's just outside for ball number one, so 1-0 count. Two outs in the top of the fourth inning. Outside for ball number two. So two balls, no strikes, two outs in the at the middle for strike number one. So 2-1 now for Maddie Schmidt. The 2-1 pitch. Inside for strike number two. So 2-2-2. Two balls, two strikes, and two outs here in the top of the fourth inning. The 2-2 pitch is slightly hit to the pitcher, Jensen. She's able to get the first in. She's safe. So, Schmidt, her 15 stolen bases, is able to easily get to first base. So now there'll be a runner on first with two outs.
Now batting for UNLV, the second baseman, number 7, Justine Fideri.
Currently up now for the UNLV Rebels is Justine Fideri. The second baseman currently is 0-for-1 today with a walk. There to this game is batting 330 with 28 RBIs and 9 home runs. Now the second most in the current Rebels lineup, just behind Samantha Diaz. That one outside again for ball number two. Samantha Diaz was tied with Fideri with 9 home runs apiece, but after the 3-run home run by Samantha Diaz, she now leads the team with 10. The 2-0 pitch. Outside again for ball three, so a favorable count for Justine Fideri as she now has a 3-0 count with Matty Schmidt at first base. Currently on the season, Schmidt has 15 stolen bases in 16 attempts. The 3-0 pitch, they're called that one strike one, so 3-1 now. Beautiful day here in Reno, Nevada for our senior day. 64 degrees, just a little windy, but a good day for some softball. The pitch, called that one a strike. So now full count for Justine Fedeli, 3-2-2. The 3-2 pitch, that one's hit to the shortstop Gutierrez, who throws at the first. A nice catch by Sam Oliver to get out of the inning. So another throw as the UNLV Rebels and Nevada Wolfpack tied at 4 apiece, heading into the bottom of the fourth inning. Heading into the bottom of the fourth inning, the final game of this three-game series between the UNLV Rebels and the Nevada Wolfpack is currently tied at 4 apiece. Each team also has a pair of 6 home runs. Sam Oliver now up to bat. Oliver has 1-for-1 and make that 2-for-2, and she hits that one between the third baseman and shortstop. So, first pitch and a first hit for Sam Oliver in the inning as Elijah Rivas takes the batter's box. Looks like the Wolfpack might make a pinch running change.
Now, pinch running at first base for the Wolfpack. Number 10, Bella Cordonaway.
Now currently pinch running for the Wolfpack is Bella Cordonaway from Carson City, Nevada. Cordonaway pinch ran twice in both games of the doubleheader yesterday. The first pitch, one's bunted right at the middle. That will move Cordonaway to second. Throw to second not in time, so Cordonaway now on second, so the sacrifice bunt by Elia Rivas works to move the runner from first to second. So now runner in scoring position for the top of the Wolfpack lineup as Chelly Sannini comes up to the batter's box. And one's high and to the left for ball number one. So 1-0 count for the Reno native Chelly Sannini. The 1-0 pitch. That one up and high for ball number two. Sannini currently on the day is 0-for-1 with a strikeout and a walk. The 2-0 pitch. Outside for ball number three, so a favorable count for Chelly Sannini as there is a runner on second in scoring position with only one out in the bottom of the fourth inning. Sunini looking for her second walk of the day. The pitch, that one called strike one, 3-1 now. Three balls, one strike, one out in the bottom of the fourth inning. Bella Cordonaway, pinch running at second base after a Sam Oliver single. That one's fouled to the UNLV dugout for strike number two. So full count now for Chelly Sunini. The full count pitch. That one's fouled, but will roll to the left side where the UNLV dugout is. So still full count for Chelly Sunini. Currently on the softball season, the Wolfpack are 21-15 overall, while the UNLV Rebels are 25-14. The full count pitch. Swing and a miss, so make that two strikeouts now for Chelly Sunini this game, as that brings up Sidaria McAllister, her second at bat of the game, hit a triple, which led to her scoring the tying run to make this game currently 4-4. The first pitch, swing and a miss, so 0-1 early for McAllister's at bat. So currently McAllister is 1-2 on the day. The 0-1 pitch, one up and high for ball number one, so 1-1. Conaway on second as the base runner, two outs in the bottom of the fourth. The 1-1 pitch, that one half swing by McAllister, and they'll say she didn't go, so 2-1 now in McAllister's at bat. McAllister currently in the series has three RBIs, all coming from the doubleheader yesterday. One in the first game, two in the second game. The pitch, that one grounded to the shortstop. She drops it, so McAllister will make it to first. Looks like they'll probably be ruled an error. So now runners on the corner for the Wolfpack. Two outs with Lauren Gutierrez, the Wolfpack leader in RBIs, up to the batter's box. Looks like the shortstop, Samantha Diaz, must have tried to pull the ball out of her glove a little early as it fell out. That one fouled to left field, so 0-1 count early for Lauren Gutierrez, the shortstop out of Upland, California. The 0-1 pitch, that one hit, and we'll get past the second baseman. That will score a run, so that'll give the Wolfpack a 5-4 lead as Cordonaway scores from third. McAllister will move to second. A RBI for the RBI leader in the Wolfpack, Lauren Gutierrez, as the Wolfpack take a 5-4 lead with Sierra Mello, who has a 2-run home run on the day already, is up to bat with two runners on. First, second, two outs. The first pitch outside for ball number one, 1-0 count. Impressive series also for Lauren Gutierrez, as that one is called ball two. Now currently has four RBIs so far this series.